will happen even before Easter Sunday, but more so on that particular Sunday afternoon.
From Sister
Dapat
adhere to your schedules, okay, for your practices. And one important thing is April 13th is general rehearsal after our Sunday service. There is also another one, the dress rehearsal.
All right.
So general rehearsal, okay, there's two. General rehearsal after the service on April 13th. And the dress rehearsal will be that Saturday, the day before the presentation, 1 to 4 o'clock in the afternoon, that Saturday, the venue is here, right? Okay, so cast, you know who you are, okay? And then, post-encounter, there will be a lesson after the service. So we have to meet Pastor Roy, right?
Yeah, for the men. They'll have snacks downstairs and they'll just move to the room.
After the snacks, you come back and meet Pastor Roy.
While having their snacks.
Oh, while they're having your snacks.
Yes.
Okay. To the boardroom. Yeah. Okay, guys. So men, those who attended the post-encounter, meet Pastor Roy. You can bring your snacks there in the boardroom and meet him there. To, just to minimize the time, because I believe some of you will be still a part of the presentation. And also our congregational prayer meeting will be held on Friday, this Friday, April 11. It's very important that we will support this, okay? You know, we have needs and we have the needs of the church. It's very important that we gather. And good news for you, you will have no tribe meeting, okay? But the tribes that are not coming to the prayer meeting, then you have to meet on your day. But we encourage everyone, please come and join with us during the prayer meeting. Very important. Okay, so last one, just a reminder, this will be in July, but it's good to be prepared so that we have enough time. You cannot say that, oh, it's too short notice, but so that's why we are trying to encourage you already and trying to remind you already to save up already for our summer camp. Okay, that will be in July 25 to 27. And we have exciting time last year. We are expecting for more exciting this year. Okay, so tribe leaders, please remind your people to start already saving for registration for July. Amen. So that's our announcement for today. And of course, I would like to welcome our first-time visitors. And when I call your name, please stand up so that we can acknowledge you. I would like to welcome Genevieve Saltori, invited by Sister Bar. And of course, Sister Margaret Cantos, invited by Sister Gemma. Thank you so much for visiting with us. And also, Rosie Gonzalez, invited by George. Thank you so much for visiting with us, and I'm sure that you are blessed as you, that you are here. I believe that it's not an accident that you are here this afternoon, but it's abundant time that you are here to join with us, worshiping the Lord. Amen? So, we after the service, please stay a little bit. We have snacks downstairs so that we can still get to know more of you and we can have more fellowship with you. Okay? So, let's go for our tithes and offerings. In Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9, it says there, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. So here we are, you know, we are instructed here to honor the Lord with our wealth, with the first fruits of your crops. And then you will say, you'll tell me, but Sister Nelpa, we are not farming. We have no fruits to bring here, but brothers and sisters, we have jobs, right? Yeah. So with our what we have, with our income, we bring the first fruits, the best to God. So this afternoon we are privileged, and we are, you know, it's a privilege to bring our tithes and offerings here in the house. But those who are visiting, of course, you are not obliged. Maybe you are just visiting, you have your own home church, then your tithes belong to your own home church. But of course, if the Holy Spirit is speaking to you and you want to give your offering, you are more than welcome. Amen? And just a reminder, please write your name in your envelope so that at the end of the year you will be tax receipting. Okay, that's one of our benefits here in Canada, that the governments are giving back, you know, a portion of what we give to the charities, to the church. Amen? Yeah. So as you prepare your envelopes, if you don't have envelopes there, just raise your hands and our usher will distribute it to you. I think you have some there in your pews, but if you don't, just raise your hands and our ushers will give it to you. So let's pray for our tithes and offerings. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you so much for everything that you're doing in our life and what you will do in our life, Lord. Truly, oh God, we are so privileged, we are so blessed that you have provided for everything that we need, oh God, Lord. We are so so blessed, oh God, that we lack nothing because we know that you are there for us, that you provide for everything that we need, Lord. So, Father, today we just acknowledge you and we just want to honor you, O God, with the first fruits of our crops, O God, Lord. And we bring it to you, Lord God. And I just pray that you will use this, O God, in the furtherance of your kingdom. Especially, O God, to win the lost, O God, for your glory, Lord God. And Father, I just lift up to you here, O God, in the house, those who are still seeking for jobs, that you will open doors of opportunity for them, O God, and provide jobs for them, the necessary, O God, Lord, the appropriate jobs that they are seeking for, Lord God. Lord, you just open doors of opportunity, O God, and provide for them so that they too will be able to bring their tithes and offering to you, Lord, and they will be able to provide for their family. Thank you so much, oh God, for everything. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy, for your love, and for all the provision that you have given to us. In all these things we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Brother Franco.
Thank you. It was quite an experience when we went to Israel because first it was our 25 years anniversary. And the Sea of Galilee was really an experience for me because when Pastor Jerry preached about the storms in life, it really applied to me. There are things that you're not in control in life, but if you trust the Lord, if you know who's in the boat, then you have that peace. And the Lord will never leave you, and He will see you through the storms. And this will be the last testimony and culmination of the Israel or Israel trip. And I will show you a very short video on, because we're promoting this for next year. We want you to be there. Okay? We want you to be there. All right, and can we have the second video?